I'm Dr. Vanshika Gupta Adukia, founder of Utherapy, pregnancy, lactation and childbirth specialist, pelvic floor physiotherapist. So today I'm here to talk to you about something which is, I think, running crucially on the minds of anybody who's close to delivery right now. There's a new rule that's come out in many states in India that before going in for delivery, you need to get yourself tested at least 15 days in advance for COVID-19. I have parents who are getting in touch with me to understand if this is a necessity. They want to know if it's something that they must look at getting done. Simply for the reason, to get tested for COVID-19, you would have to head to a hospital. They're worried about getting exposed to the virus. They're worried about not having the virus, but going into a hotspot and probably contracting it. To all those people, my message is this. See, at the end of it, this is being conducted to keep in mind the safety first of patients around, pregnant moms around, and newborns as well. We've had cases previously in the country where certain mothers delivered, and after 2 to 3 days, it was realized that these moms were actually positive for COVID-19, and therefore it became a threat to the newborn, to the doctors, to the nurses, and the medical system as well where they have delivered. So I would urge you that take whatever precautions need to be taken, mask yourself, glove yourself, sanitize well, head to the nearest institute that is offering you to take the COVID-19 test and test before you head in for your delivery. Apart from this, when you are going in for your delivery, I think it's going to be very essential to keep in mind that certain things which we were otherwise expecting, for example, our partner with us in the delivery room, is something which might not be as flexible at the moment and may not be allowed. Please don't get disheartened by this. This is again only to keep everybody's safety in mind, and it's something which we would have to abide by. Other than that, if you are somebody who is currently pregnant, I would urge you to get in touch with your specialist, your gynecologist, and consider the option of taking an influenza vaccination as well if you currently haven't taken one. It's very, very safe to take in pregnancy as well. Now, talking a little bit about those who have probably delivered. If you're somebody who, for whatever reason, I'm not saying you're COVID positive, but if you're running any kind of cold, cough, fever, I would urge you to please breastfeed the baby with a mask on. Okay, that's going to make sure that there is no droplet that's getting transferred to the baby. This is only if you have any symptom whatsoever. If you have tested positive for COVID-19, it is a good idea if you wish not to breastfeed. It's an option that would be left onto you. You could look at expressing your breast milk and then having that fed to the baby. For all those of us who have delivered and brought our babies home, now I know this is a time where you know you are keeping anxious for the safety of your child and yourself. Please keep in mind to reduce visitors to a bare minimum. Hospitals as such are not allowing anybody except one attendant with the person who has delivered, which is the mum. In most cases, it's the father. Please try and make sure that you stick to one attendant throughout your visit at the hospital. After coming home as well, cut down on visitors as far as possible. Avoid letting anybody from outside enter home. When it comes to the baby, ensure that you're sanitizing anything and everything that's used for the child. So use sanitize before and after. It could be simply washing with water and soap. It could be disinfecting. It could be for certain things, you could even look at putting it in hot water and leaving it like that. Look at sun drying things. If it's clothes, if it's utility stuff, if it's toys, you could even look at sun drying them or leaving them in the sun for 24 hours. So please sanitize before use and after use. This would ensure that we are trying to keep whatever is around the baby germ free, because children are known to immediately mouth things. So that's something you can look after. Another thing that you can do is please try and ensure that if things are going well, you resort to telecommunication or video consults with your pediatrician or your gynecologist post delivery, because routine checkups that normally happen at 7 days, 10 days, 14 days or even a month benchmark would not be something which could be the best thing to do at the moment. So doing a video call or doing a telephone call, if your gynec or your pediatrician feels is enough, could be something that you could look forward to. Apart from this, vaccinations are something which most new moms or parents are getting concerned about. Well, at this point of time, your best resort would be to get in touch with your pediatrician. Most pediatricians are okay to delay the vaccination as far as possible, provided you fall in the stipulated window where we can delay the vaccine. So if you are landing up skipping a vaccine due to the coronavirus right now and to prevent yourself and your child from being exposed to an environment which could be a hotspot, I think it would be a good idea. Please, I know it's a difficult time, but look at keeping yourself calm, look at positivity towards you, but keep safe. It's better to keep smart and safe rather than risk any of our health at this point of time. Thank you.